Hey guys, I'm Isil Khan, and in this video, we're going to talk about resource leveling in project management. Now, before talking about resource leveling, the first thing I want to talk about is like what they are. I mean, what are resources? So resources can be of different categories like equipment, labor, material. Okay, these are the three categories of resources. Now, equipments are resources which are not permanently installed on site. These are temporary resources. For example, you can take an example of an excavator. An excavator does excavate and digs, you can say, soil, and then it is taken away from the site. So an excavator can be an equipment, okay? So this is an example. Now labors, these are, you can say, the manpower, okay? Labor are resources with fixed salaries, you can say. So these are main powers, and the material, these are permanent resources. Labors are also not permanent, okay? These can be changed with the time. That does not matter. Okay, so material, however, are permanently installed on the site. Like you can say, if you construct a building or a shopping mall, you can say. So a building can be constructed of brickwork, stonework, and those are permanent things. Those are permanent resources installed on the site. Okay. All right. Now, what are resource leveling? How do we do resource leveling? Actually, resource leveling can be the minimalization of variations resource used during project. Okay. And what does this mean? I'm going to represent this thing, and I'm going to discuss this with the graphic representation, you can say. And let's say I'm going to draw a graph of days in resources. Okay. These resources gonna represent the labor. Okay, wait a minute, if I can draw it better. Okay, all right. Now we got a limitation from the company side, like you can say this one, and the limitation can be in terms, like you can say, if an activity needs 15 number of labors, and the company does provide and can provide only 10 labors per day. So 10 labors is the limitation, you can say. It is the limit that a company can provide. Okay, all right. So we got a limit over here, this one. Okay, now as you can see, we got something about the limit. The resources are gone about the limit. We're gonna bring these resources down into the limit, you can say. Okay, this is called resource leveling. Like you can say this one, this. Okay, if you look to the graph, there are ups and downs. Okay, and we're gonna level them. We're gonna bring the ups into the down, okay, like date. So as you can see, this one, this portion can be brought just over here to this point, and the another one like those can be brought over there. Okay, so this is called leveling. Okay, resource leveling. We have leveled the resources like in this form. Now the graph can be seen in this form. Okay, all right. So what is the process? How do we do it? Okay, it is not that easy, okay, to bring the ups into the downs. Okay, so this is not that easy. We're gonna analyze, we're gonna work with the critical paths. Okay, though there can be critical activities, so it is a little tricky, and I'm gonna go ahead for an example, because an example can be a better way to understand some things. All right, so let's say I'm gonna have an example, and I'm gonna jump into an Excel like this one. Okay, all right, what we're gonna do, you can say resource, wait a minute, leveling. All right, and let's say we got activity, then their predecessors, the duration of activity, and then we have the labors. Okay, actually I'm gonna take an example from my side. Like you can say activity A, activity B, activity C, activity D, E, up to E. I'm happy with that. I'm okay with that. Does not matter. All right. Let's say activity A and B gonna start at the same time. So these guys does not have predecessors, and activity C can start once activity A is completed, you can say. I'm not talking about the relations. Okay. The other relations, it is finished to start relation, you can say. Okay, not other relations, because I'm gonna make this calculation little simple, and in another example we're gonna go ahead little tricky. All right, activity D does have predecessors A and B, and then for E we got C and D. Okay, and the durations, I'm gonna add them just like date. Okay, not a huge deal to work with. And the labors, we got 4 labors per activity A, and then 2, and then 6, and then 3, and 3 are okay. All right. Okay, so these are activities, predecessor, and the labors. I'm gonna make this one, okay. Like for activity E, we need 1 number of labor. Okay, that's good. Now, what we're gonna do, we're gonna label them, okay. How do we label them? Here is the limitation, okay. The company can provide 7 labors per day, okay. So we got limitation, like you can say, the company can provide only 7 number of labors per day. All right, that's good. We got limitation over here. And another thing we're gonna do over here is we're gonna draw the network diagram, because network diagram gonna help us to determine the critical path, and then that gonna help us in resource allocation and leveling. Okay, so we're gonna draw critical path, and then we're gonna allocate resources. Okay, and then thirdly we're gonna level the resources. This is what we're gonna do. Okay, however, we can do another thing is to determine the slack or floats. Okay, and how these guys gonna help us. Okay, I'm gonna talk about these guys little late in the calculation over here, and in the solution we're gonna do it. All right, so what I'm gonna do is to draw the network diagram. This is gonna be our first approach, you can say, and then I'm gonna jump into the same presentation, and this is the same table. Okay, we did just and we enter just a few seconds ago in Excel worksheet. Okay, so we got activities, predecessor, duration, labors, and now we're gonna draw the network diagram from this, and I'm gonna do it later roughly. Okay, like you can say activity A and B, this can be the project start. Okay, if you don't know how to draw a network diagram, I have already uploaded another video, a separate video on this approach. You can watch that little late or just before this video. Link to that video is down below in the video description. All right, so activity C can start when the activity A is completed, like this one. Okay, and then we have activity D, so that is from A and B, and then we have activity E, which is from C and D, and then the project end. Okay, so this is a rough work, and I'm gonna do a detailed work now and determining the early start, late start, early finish, and late finish, you can say. Okay, so this is the same network diagram as I did just a few seconds ago. Okay, like this one. And now we're gonna calculate the early start, early finish, late start, and late finish, because these guys gonna you can say help us to determine the plot of each activity. Okay, all right, so the project start, the early start of project can be 0. Okay, so 0 plus 0, that is the early finish of the project start, and then we're gonna bring this 0 to A and B. Okay, like this one, and we're gonna add 3 with 0, which is the early finish of activity B. All right, and then we're here the 0, and then 0 plus 2, that is of course 2, which is the early finish of activity A, you can say. Okay, and then we got activity D, which got 2 predecessors, as you can see, A and B. Okay, now the video of its early start can be the maximum video from one of these two, from A and B, which can be the maximum video, and that is of course 3. Okay, 3 is actually the early finish of activity B. Okay, all right, so and that is because in forward pass we take the maximum video, okay, from the predecessor. All right, so 3 plus 3, that is gonna be 6 this time. Okay, is the early finish of activity D. And over here we got 2, it is the same thing, and 2 plus 1, and it's of course 3. Now activity E, it is the same thing, okay, it got the same situation as activity D has, alright. So the one with maximum value can be taken. Like as you can see, activity D have the early finish is 6 and activity C got early finish is 3. So we're gonna take 6 one, okay. So 6 plus 2, that is gonna be 8, and the same 8 gonna go there, okay, and plus 0. So that is 8. Alright. Now backward pass can be the same process. We're gonna bring this 8 to the E. Wait a minute, just like that. And we're gonna subtract 2, which is the duration of E, and that is gonna be 6. And this time we're gonna bring this 6 over here is the late finish of activity D, and we're gonna subtract 3 from that, so that's gonna be 3. And over here, 6 minus 1, that's gonna be 5. And the next thing, we're gonna bring this 3 over here, and 3 minus 3, that's gonna be 0. Okay, I'm gonna do this thing little quickly, okay, because I don't want the video to be longer, okay. But detailed calculation, I'm gonna repeat that you can watch the same separated video in the same channel in the same playlist. Link to that video is down below in the video description. All right, the next thing is, as you can see, we got activity A, and we're gonna bring the small value from activity D and C, and that is of course 3, okay, like that. And 3 minus 2, that is of course 1. And now activity, this is actually not activity, but we can call it activity as the project start. It is of course the project start, so it can be an activity. And the small value over here we got is 0, so we're gonna bring that 0, and 0 minus 0, that is of course 0. Okay, this means the calculation is okay when you got 0, okay, is the early start and early finish for the project start. All right, the next thing which I'm gonna calculate is the total float and the free float. And the total float can be of course 0 minus 0, that is of course 0, okay, because total float can be the late start minus early start, or you can say the late finish minus early finish, okay. So 0 minus 0, that is gonna be 0. Par B, we have of course 0, because 0 minus 0, that is 0, or you can say 3 minus 3, that is of course 0. And par A, we have 1 minus 0, which is of course 1, or you can say 3 minus 2, that is also of course 1. It's gonna be the same, okay. And then next we got of course the total float equals 0 per activity D. Per activity C, we have of course 3, because 5 minus 2, that is of course 3. Per activity E, we got the same thing, 0, and per the project end, that is of course 0. So now we can determine, we can locate the critical path over here. The critical path can be the path, okay, joining the activities with 0 floats or slacks. You can say B, D, activity E, and the end of the project. So these are critical activities, and the path joined by these guys, or the path created by these guys, is known by the critical path. Okay, so we got the total float, and then we're gonna calculate the free float. And this can be, as you can see, if I'm gonna calculate the free float for the project start, it gonna be the early startup activity B, which is 0, minus the early startup activity PS, which is 0. So 0 minus 0, that is gonna 0, and then minus the duration of PS, which is again 0. So the free float is also 0 per activity PS. Okay, and then per activity B, that is also 0. Okay, how that comes? Of course 3 minus 0, which is of course 3, and then minus the duration of B, which is of course 0. Alright, and then per activity A, it is of course 0. Per activity D, that is 0. Per activity C, that is 3. And how? Because 6 minus 2, that is of course 4. And the duration of C is 1. So 4 minus 1, that is of course 3. And so on. Do the same. Okay, so once we got the total float, free float, early start, and early finish, you can say, then of course we're gonna jump into the same presentation and the same Excel sheet over here, and I'm gonna add those guys as we calculated, like the total float, free float, early start, early finish. And I'm gonna enter the values little quickly, okay, because don't wanna waste the time. Like you can say, oh, wait a minute, it's 1, okay, then 0, 3, 0, 0. These are the total float per each activity, okay. Like you can say, per activity A, we got the total float equals 1. And I'm gonna confirm it if it's okay or not. Our activity A, where is it? Its total float is equal 1. Yes, that's okay. All right, now the total, okay, float is done, and the free float, that was 0 per activity A, 0, 3, 0, 0. What are actually these guys? The total float. Total float can be the delay of inactivity, okay, which does not delay the total project duration, you can say. And the free float can be the float or the delay of inactivity, which does not affect actually the start of its intermediate, you can say, okay. All right, now early start can be 0, 0, 2, and 3, of course 6, all right. And then for the early finish, we got 2, 3, and of course 3, and then 6 and 8. It was the early finish of activity E, and I'm gonna confirm it a little bit. Yes, that's okay. All right, again, jumping into Excel sheet. All right, now what I'm gonna do is to do a resource allocation. Okay, so for this approach, I'm gonna make a table, okay, like activity, wait a minute, activity, and these are of course A, B, C, D, and E. And then I'm gonna enter the days and then the labors, okay. And this can be of course the allocation, okay. I'm gonna wait a minute. I'm gonna insert one column over here, one row, and I'm gonna call this resource allocation, okay. All right, just a minute, okay. All right, so now activity A. What we got per activity A over here, as you can see, we got 4 labors, but the duration is 2 days, okay. As you can see, we just wait a minute, I'm gonna enter these guys like date 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 days, okay. The total duration of the project is 8 days, so up to 8 we're gonna go. All right, now activity A is up 2 days, as you can see the duration. And we got 4 labors, so activity A is 2 days 4. That means for 2 days we need 4 labors per activity A only, okay. All right, now for activity B, where is activity B? We got 3 days, the labors are 2, okay. And as you can see, activity A and B start at the same time, so we're gonna enter these guys who are here, 2, 2, and 2 for 3 days, okay, because the duration of B is 3 days. All right, and then we got activity C, okay, with duration is 1 day in 6 labors, so it can be over here, okay, 6 labors, because activity A once completed, then activity C can start. As you can see, activity C got predecessor is A, okay. So A is completed over here up to this, and then activity C can start over here, all right, at day 3, you can say. All right, now next we got activity D. All right, the duration is 3 days with 3 labors, okay. This means at day 4 activity D can start. How? Because activity D does have predecessor A and B, okay. It means A and B must be completed before starting the activity D, okay. So activity B completes over here, and then activity D can start from this point, okay. And it got 3 days with 3 labors, so 3, 3, and 3, just like this, okay. We're gonna fill the row for activity D. And then lastly, activity E, it is of course up 2 days and 1 labor, so we have 2 days remaining, 1 labor and 1 labor over there. Now we're gonna mark the critical activities and how we do that from the total float. Okay, activity B, D, E, these are critical activities. We can't do any changes with this guy, okay? Because if we delay anything in these activities, it gonna result in the delaying all projects. So B is critical activity, D and E are critical activities. D, this one is critical, and E, this one is also critical. So in resource leveling, we cannot change these guys. These resources cannot be changed and cannot be, of course, replaced with another activities. Like that you can say, it's gonna affect all the project, you can say. All right, now next, what I'm gonna do, we're gonna add all the labors, like 4 plus 2, that's of course 6 labor. We need 6 labor per day 1. Per day 2, we need 6 labors again. Okay, and then on day 3, we got 6 plus 2, that's of course 8. And wait a minute, just as you can see, over here we got the company can provide only 7 number of labors per day. And on day 3, we got 8 labors. We need 8 labors actually. Okay, I'm gonna make this guy a little bit red. So, and I'm gonna go ahead further. I'm gonna come over here again. All right, now on day 4, we need 3 labors. On day 5, we need 3 labors. On day 6, we need 3 labors. On day 7, we need 1 labor. And on day 8, we need 1 labor. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is to do resource leveling. Okay, and how we gonna do it? As you can see, we have only problem with day 3. All right, and just a minute, I'm gonna make them all border, and then I'm gonna copy them, and just a minute, and paste them over here, and I'm gonna call this leveled resources. All right, okay, now what I'm gonna do is to work with activity CRA, because these are non-critical activities, their duration can be changed, which does not affect actually the total duration of the project. However, we can't work with activity B, activity D, and activity E, because these are critical activities. As you can see over here, okay, these guys got the float of 0. All right, and activity A, as you can see, we have float equals 1, and activity C, we have float equals 3. So these guys can be changed their location or their duration. Okay, all right, and how we can do it? We're gonna bring this 4 just little bit over here. Okay, then 4 plus 1 equals 5, and it is okay over there. All right, but activity A and B gonna start at the same time, so I'm not gonna work with date. However, I'm gonna work with C. Okay, is activity C got 6 labors. All right, how I'm gonna do it? I'm gonna check the float of activity C, the free float. As you can see over here, activity C, and its free float is 3 units. Okay, so that means we're gonna delay, and we can delay activity C for how much days? For 3 days, you can see. Okay, so I'm gonna delay this for 1 day. Okay, just wait a minute, cross, these are 3 days, and I'm gonna bring this guy over here. What do you say now? Okay, again, I'm gonna add these things. Okay, like it is the same 6, it is the same 6. Now over here we got 2 labors only. Okay, this means we have done resource leveling. And over here we got 3 labors, 3 labors, and here we have 7 labors. That's good, really good. And over here we have only 1 labor. Alright, this means we are now okay. We are okay. We have done the resource leveling. Okay, like as you can see, we have up to 7 labors, and the company can provide, of course, 7 labors per day. That's called leveling. Okay, you can also make you can, of course, it's chart. The chart can be also made in Excel manually. You can do it like it was shown in the presentation. Okay, this one, the days and labors chart. Okay, This is not my approach. My approach was to determine and do the resource leveling. Okay, it was for the labors, for other resources. We're gonna do another example in the next video, inshallah. So wait for a date and see you next time, and wassalam.